because I don't know how long she's going to take. Not complaining. Oh, there she is. There she is. Hold on. I can't hear you. Oh, there we go. Well, yes, I can hear you.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Okay.
Hi, Mrs. Mama.
Hi.
We've already got 5 people in.
Really?
Yeah.
I see 0 on the screen.
It says 3 watching now. Thomas is here.
Okay. Hi.
And speaking of Thomas, hold on.
My hair is messy.
Mama Otome is here.
Hi, Otome.
Good morning.
Otome means woman.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mama woman? Like
a woman, but like girl or...
Mama girl?
Lady.
Okay. She's not more mama than you are, though. Because you're Mrs. Mama.
Mama's mama.
Right, right. Yeah, there's Judy.
Hi, Judy.
Judy left a comment on my video. She said, I saw the pink.
What video?
My hurricane video from the typhoon video yesterday.
Yeah, the wall.
Yeah. She said, I saw the pink. Yeah.
Yeah, that pink. It'll be pink. Not in a couple months, I guess.
Mama Otome says it's a reference to the genre of video games.
Yeah, well, Japanese otome in Japanese means lady.
Oh, okay. Very
more
cool.
To younger lady.
Okay. All right. Well, let's oh, it's Jess.
Okay. Hi, Jess.
Yeah, to be fair, what I'm seeing on the screen. The what you call it?
I saw her comment. Yeah.
No. What I'm seeing on the screen, the little avatar. I can't see it.
Oh.
It's too small.
Jesse, Mama, Jesse, hi.
Look.
What?
See how small those are? I can't see those.
Okay.
Those are tiny. Oh.
Well, get your face closer to the screen. You can see it.
So that's why. Hold on. Oh, damn. What I do now? Okay, there we go. Let's see here. Okay. Shut down the wrong thing.
Okay.
So let me do the pop out chat over here before we do the official start here. Pop out chat here. You know, I don't need the pop out chat, do I? Just follow the chat as it comes on here, right? Don't follow the YouTube one.
Yeah, either way.
Okay.
You get a little bit earlier than I seem on my
right,
screen.
Exactly. Right? Yeah. So let's I will not look at the YouTube comments and I'll just look at them here.
Okay.
That way I'm not getting them 20 seconds before you.
Okay.
Okay. So if you guys feel like your comments are not being seen, give it time. Jess says the otome is like maiden in direct translation.
Oh,
the genre is directed for women, dating games, etc. to them, so it's called otome.
In a game, I guess. Then,
yeah,
the general meaning. All right,
let's get this started because we got questions coming in here that I want to answer.
Okay.
Good morning, last night.
Good morning, last night.
Now, do you guys know why we name this show "Good Morning, Last Night"? It's pretty simple reason. It's morning here. It's nighttime there.
Oh, so, is that what it is?
Yeah. So good morning last night. Cause we're saying good morning to them, right?
Yeah.
Cause
the last night for us.
Right. It's last night for us, right? Where they're at. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah. So that's just something I came up with. I thought it was a cute name. Anywho, good morning last night. I hope everybody's doing well. As you know, we had a super typhoon run through here yesterday. But if you saw my video that I put up yesterday, that's about the worst that we got where we're at.
We were again lucky.
Yeah, we were extremely fortunate. And I think it's got a lot to do with the location of our house. Because, I mean, we're on the coast like everybody else. You know, it's not like we're, you know, 60 miles inland or anything like that. We were just, you know, we're just very fortunate that we didn't.
Well, Luke, even
saying good noon to you, right?
Same
good afternoon last night.
Different area in the same city. There's a flood and close the streets and stuff like that. So we are, at least our neighborhood was very fortunate.
Yeah, we didn't get anything.
Opie and I had a walk this morning to check out the streets and river. We have a river not too far from here.
Right.
And we checked the river last night too. It was full water. And this morning was a little bit less, but the water still runs really fast. But I didn't see any the trees fall down or garbage can was sitting on the middle of the street. Nothing like that. I can't hear you. I can't hear you.
Sorry. Or maybe there's some leaves on the ground.
Okay.
I turned my mic off because I'm eating the cracker and I didn't want to. Okay. For people who are watching this, that you're seeing me, you know, chew on a cracker over here. Before we started, I started getting the shakes. My blood sugar's a little low, so Tomoko brought me some crackers.
Yeah.
So I'm just eating those.
Yeah. There was flood in somewhere in a city, and water went over from the river and a different river, but
yeah, a lot of places got flooded. Yeah. Like Jess is saying, Zach was showed pictures of the new Shinkansen underwater. Yeah. And there were places here in Shizuoka where we saw people walking in the street in knee deep water.
Right. Yeah.
That didn't happen here. Like we just, you know, we just had some heavy rain and a little bit of wind. I mean, it wasn't too windy either. Yeah. So I, like I said, I think it's the position of our house being wedged in between all these other houses that we just didn't get in.
Yeah. And we're located very far from ocean. And
well, you're not near the ocean, but by typhoon hurricane standards, we're not far from the ocean. We're only about 8 miles, 10 miles. Yeah.
Isn't that not far enough?
What's that?
Isn't that not far enough?
No.
Really?
No, we were in the red zone for sure.
I didn't have any fear of it. And no mountains have a fear of the mudslides around us.
Right. Okay, now we can come back to this.
Okay.
First thing, Thomas has a new avatar.
Okay. Oh.
And let's see.
Check that.
Hold on. He says, look, the new profile pic. There we go.
There you go. Good boy. That's the right picture of Mount Fuji.
Nice. And it's got the tea fields too, right? Very Shizuoka.
I think it's from the Makinohara, the picture probably taken.
Very nice. Okay. And then Lucas was asking, hope I don't miss anybody. Lucas was asking, have the cooking videos been made? And he says, I haven't seen them. Okay.
So you explain.
You guys see that big smile come across Tomoko's face on that one, huh? Have the cooking videos been made? Well, the answer to that is a big yes. And I haven't seen them. The answer to that is a big yes. Because I didn't put them up.
There's a reason.
Yeah. Okay. So we. Well, it's not really your fault. Well, it is, but it's not. It's just a little mistake. Huge mistake.
In my defense, the package of the curry roux has a recipe on the back of the box package, and I checked the recipe a couple times to make sure that I was doing right. It turned out to be that I was wrong. Go ahead. Hello.
Was the recipe on the back
I follow the amount there.
Okay, let me get to this before, so people understand what's going on here. By amounts and stuff like that. Okay, so we went to make a video of the Japanese curry,
right?
And it was pretty good. Like while she was preparing, I would shoot some video, and then we'd have like a downtime of a couple minutes where, you know, we couldn't do anything. And at that time, I would run the video over to the computer, get it off my phone, start editing, you know, blah 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 blah. And I'd go back and shoot some more. And so over the course of the night, from start to finish, with the, because we were shooting and everything, we worked about 2.5-3 hours, right?
Yeah.
Something like that. We covered about 3 hours, everything involved, right?
Yeah.
So everything went really well. And the moment of truth came. And we actually said that, the moment of truth. You actually said that when you opened it. Tomoko says, it's time for the moment of truth. And she twists the top open. And, you know, maybe there'll be an outtake video on this. And we'll show that scene. We open it up. And it's like, it wasn't curry. It was a big pot of soup. It was just water with vegetables floating in it. And she's stirring it. She sticks to this thing. She says, maybe I need to stir it a little bit. And she starts stirring. And she says, she says, this is a little watery. So what happened was, here's what happened was. Yeah. Jess says, I always use more than the curry package says, or else the sauce feels too thin. Yeah. Not like this. You don't. So what happened was, like I told you guys last week earlier, Tomoko had made a pot of chicken noodle soup. Now you see where this is going. The amount of chicken broth that she used in the curry was the amount that she was supposed to use in the chicken noodle soup. Right. So whereas the recipe called for 2 cans of chicken broth, she used 4. So we had, where it called for 2 cups, she used 8. So we had 8 cups of chicken broth instead of 2 cups. That's what it was.
Right.
So we ended up with this pot full of curry flavored soup. Now, to be totally fair, it was good.
Yeah.
I mean, it was just soup. It wasn't curry.
But surprisingly, the taste wasn't thin.
Yeah, no, it tasted
at all.
It was just curry soup.
Yeah.
And we ended up eating the whole thing. It took a couple days, but we got through it. But that's what it was. So what we're going to do is we're going to keep all the footage that we have, and we're going to make curry one more time and switch out the parts. She's going to wear the same clothes that she wore. Or maybe you should wear different clothes. That might even be funny. That'd be a little inside joke. Wear something different. What we're going to do is we're going to switch out the part where she's putting the chicken broth in and switch out the part where she's opening the pot. So there we go.
Yeah.
Jess says you needed a bunch of cornstarch.
Yeah.
Maybe like a 5-pound bag of it.
It was that thing.
Yeah. It was soup.
Yeah. The package says, I don't know how to convert how many cups in. Says 1400 milliliters, which is 1.4 liters. I don't know how many cups for it. And in the package of the package. 1.4
liters?
Yeah.
Liters?
Liters, yeah. 1400 milliliters, which is equal as 1.4 liters.
Hold on. 1.4 liters would be the size of that Coca-Cola bottle.
Right. Oh, that's the package. That's the recipe of the package of the curry rule said. And I just ordered it.
You should probably check that again.
I checked it 10 times. Maybe
because the recipe is cooking it over the stove. Maybe a lot of the moisture burns
out. I was going to say that.
Okay.
Because we cooked in an instant pot, which is pressure cooker, and no water disappears.
Right.
Stays in. Liquid stays in the amount that we put it in.
Right.
So that 1400 milliliters, yeah, that's over, way over.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Yeah. So we'll do it one more time. Okay. Now, next up, Ed Denoy came in. He says, "How's the poison sumac? Let's see the arms, Mrs. Mama. Hold on. I'm going to drop out so you're full screen. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So you won't be able to hear me, but I'm watching. Okay.
Okay. This is my left arm. The car is totally faded. It's still there, but it's got a lot better. The less itchy. My itch is almost gone. I don't scratch my arms anymore, almost hardly ever. And swollen is gone totally. Still ugly skin, but almost. So I'm waiting for this color totally faded and got the normal skin back. My feet are still there. I have itchy thighs, but not as bad as before. I can show my back scar like this. It's a little bit dry, but a lot better. It's same thing as here. It was total red before, and now it's almost gone. Like this. So then upper part here is little red than others, but and little itchier than others, but it's not bad. I don't use cream anymore. I just let it heal by itself.
Very nice. Very nice.
I got really dry skin though.
Mm-hmm. Right. Nice and flaky.
Yeah. Yeah, almost like a dandruff.
Now, the question I have is, did the Aveeno help you?
I think so. Because I used a lot. I put at the Aveeno's a couple times a day.
Oh, okay.
Whenever I feel really itchy, I put them on my everywhere that where the itchy part.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, guess who's here, Mama?
Yes.
Guess who's here?
Who?
Sean Patrick Galen.
Oh, hi, Sean.
He says, "Y'all good from the storm?" Yeah, we're good. We're good. Yes, we are. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. Did I skip something that Judy said before? I kind of feel like I missed something. Hold on.
Okay.
Let's see.
Come here. Bobby, go. Come here.
Judy says, "Hello."
Hey, come here.
You know, maybe it's nothing here that she said. Where is Judy? Did she disappear? She said hello and that's it.
I saw her.
Did she drop out?
I don't know.
Anyway, she just posted on Facebook that she made, I think it was salmon and salmon and some carrots and all kinds of stuff in her Instant Pot.
Oh.
And then she said she wanted to thank us for the... for the recommendation, and I'm like, did we recommend salmon or did we recommend the Instant Pot?
I think Instant Pot. That's the biggest topic that we talked about last week.
Right. That's right. Last week she was talking about the meals to match everybody in the family, right?
Yeah.
Right. And if it would
have
She said in her post that she put I think if I remember correctly, I just kind of scanned it. I think she said she put everything in frozen. It came out perfect.
One lady we watched on the YouTube, she introduced the recipe Instant Pot, right? Six Sisters stuff.
Right.
She
right.
uses frozen stuff every time. She just toasts every frozen veggies, frozen meat.
Tosses it in with a cup of water. Yeah.
And I think her policy is making up cooking quick as she can. So she uses frozen veggies and meat and make a quick recipe. So yeah, frozen stuff is no problem to cook.
Yeah, right. Yeah, Jess saying they got the Ninja Foodie. Instead of the Instant Pot, you can make a full meal in that thing from frozen. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Nice.
Well, yeah, I'm completely sold on the Instant Pot. It's fantastic for hard boiled eggs.
Yes.
Like we've done that four yes. times so far, right?
Yeah, it's the easiest cooking ever. Mm. All you need is just put the cup of water in the little stand. Yeah, there's a name.
I don't know.
It came with the Instant Pot. It's like a little tool.
Right.
And it's just put the raw eggs in there and then pour the water. Put the cup of water in and put that thing in and put eggs on top of them. Mm. And just close the lid and let it go.
Judy says she got the Instant Pot from... We'll come back to that one, Sean. I bought the Instant Pot from Costco. It's great. Okay, Judy, I have a question for you. This is a huge question. Just in my interest. Is yours the, what's it called? Nova?
Nova Plus.
Nova Plus 6-quart? Nova Plus 6-quart. Because supposedly that's the one that's made for Costco. So I'm wondering if you got the same one that we've got. And then Sean said that he's made barbecue beef strips in the instant pressure cooker. Yeah.
Nice. Sounds nice already.
And Jess says she got the foodie for Chris. She was working all the time so the kids could have some variety for dinner. Yeah. Now the one thing that's kind of a cool thing on ours, on our Instapot that's in the video is that our control panel is all in Japanese.
Yeah.
On the face of the machine.
Right.
Which is cool. I didn't notice that on the box.
Mm. Yeah, there's like 10 buttons on the screen on the pot. But I've only used 3. Three so far. Saute, pressure cooker, and the plus minus.
Right. That's it. Right.
There's a preset mode like a stew, yogurt and stuff like that, but I haven't used the soup button yet.
Okay, Judy says she got the 6-quart Duo SV. Okay.
Oh.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah, we got the Nova Plus and I went searching for it and I couldn't find it. And I finally did find it and it said it's made specifically for Costco. So okay. And then Jess is asking, is the Instant Pot just a pressure cooker?
No,
it's also a karaoke machine. No. Yes. it's not a pressure cooker. You can saute and.
You can saute. You can do slow cook. You can cook rice.
Yogurt.
What else? Steam the stuff. Yeah, you don't have to use pressure to cook stuff.
Right. Yeah, it's really nice. I'm completely sold on it. Completely sold.
See?
And you're welcome. Yeah, you're right. See? You're welcome.
What?
I bought it.
What did you say? See? You bought it? No. You didn't even know till I introduced you
about that. But I gave up buying the Apple Watch for you to get the Instapot. I'm paying for it. So I get to say, see?
No, you don't have that. I do. And I thank to the Costco group on the Facebook. Somebody posted that Instapot. This person bought it and used it and introduced on the page. I happened to saw that and then I got me interested.
To be fair, you and I were talking about getting a pressure cooker like 2 years ago.
We
just never got it because they were so expensive.
Yeah, expensive.
Oh, so Judy says she got hers on Thursday. And she made dinner in it Thursday, Friday, and tonight. So he's there. You go.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So very cool. But yeah, we were talking about getting a pressure cooker years ago and we never did because of the prices. Mm-hmm. And I think if I'm not mistaken, I think when we were looking at pressure cookers, the Instant Pot wasn't on the page that we were looking at.
Yeah, we were looking at the Sys pressure cooker specifically. Right. Or a slow cooker.
Mm.
What else? There's a name of the this cooker. I don't remember, but
like the crock pot type thing.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Now Jess is saying, have we ever tried the air fryer? No. And who was it we were talking to about the air fryer?
Rodney.
No. Somebody said they got an air fryer and they hated it.
Oh really? Oh, I don't know. Well, who was it? The day we bought the Instant Pot, there was air fryer too, and I was interested in, but well, no space to buy both.
Mm.
So one or the other, but air fryers can so much can do less.
Well, Jess says that's the only difference between the Instant Pot and the foodie. I guess is the air fryer.
Oh, okay.
So the air fryer can pressure cook?
Really?
Well, she says the only difference between the Instant Pot and the foodie is the air fryer.
Mm. Maybe.
Or is it one's an air fryer and one's a pressure cooker? See, the message sent is never the message received.
It's basically the only difference between the Instant.
I
guess according to what she wrote.
She says came with a separate lid for air frying. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it is a pressure cooker.
So your foodie can do pressure cooking, I guess. Then
yeah,
we'll have to look and air frying. Is it foodie new thing? Instant Pot came out like 2-3 years ago.
Foodie Ninja zero pressure cooker, steamer, and air fryer. Yeah,
there you go.
There you go. Yeah, I got it here on Amazon. Here you go. Well, that's kind of cool looking.
Oh,
yeah, look at that.
Look like a ninja.
That's pretty badass, isn't it?
Yeah,
let's see.
And how much is it?
$189.99. Yeah, look at that. Very nice.
Well, this may takes over the price from Instant Pot.
Yeah, it's pretty badass looking, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I like the look of that. It's a neat little machine.
Hmm.
Huh.
I bet that we can't get it in Japan.
Yeah, probably not. Not yet. Jess says, yeah, it was not cheap. $189, but that sounds about right, though, doesn't it?
$220,000, about.
Yeah.
In Japanese. Well,
that sounds about right. Our Instant Pot was $15,000.
Right.
Right? And they're $25 and $30 on Amazon. For the other models, for some of the other models,
right? Well, the Ninja would price if they sell in Japan like 30,000 or so.
Sakana Kaizen says, "Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Mully. Hi. I'm old school. I stick with my Japanese nabe."
Yeah. Well, if you like cooking and you are good at it, no problem. I'm not a good cook, and I'm lazy. I prefer something can cook easily than fast.
Let's see. Nope, it's not available on Amazon Japan.
Okay.
Ninja Foodie.
Hmm.
No.
It may be,
I'm getting results of hoodies.
Hoodies like
sweatshirt. Yeah.
Sweatshirt.
Jess says she can take us on to base. Ah, to look at stuff in the Hold on, hold on, hold on. Did I miss something?
I don't know.
Is Jess back in Japan?
No, not yet. She will be coming back.
Okay, okay.
But not this year. Next year, right, Jess?
Okay, moving back in January. Okay, okay, okay. Yeah, well, we'll definitely have to get together sometime.
Mm, yeah.
Definitely have to get together. Jess, are you moving back under the same? Sorry, maybe this isn't the place for it. I'll send you a message. Just wondering what your situation is on moving back. I'll send you a message.
Mm.
Public forums, not for that kind of stuff. Okay, Sean is sending me pictures. Let's mm-hmm. see. How can I do this?
Sorry, I just read that Judy's post that I'm with you. I'm not a good cook. You're a good cook. I'm a good cook, but after years of cooking, I just got tired of cooking, mostly the cleanup. I hear you. I'm not a good cook, but I don't like cleaning. So
you're not a bad cook.
I'm not. I'm not.
Look. Okay, guys, here's how horrible Tomoko's cooking is. Look at my body. That's all the proof you need. If your food was no good, I would be super thin. But obviously I eat too much, so you're doing a pretty good job.
Thank you. I have zero confidence.
Okay, Jess says she doesn't mind. Okay. Mm. Okay, no, so Jess, I was just wondering, are you still together with what's his name? And Chris, right? Is it Chris? Yes. Yeah, sorry, you know, he pissed me off that night.
Ah.
Yeah, when we were up there. but are you coming back under those situations? And hold on, Sean, I need to get your, are you coming back with him? Let's see. Let me get Sean's pictures up here. He sent them via.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, here we go. Here we go. Gotcha. So I got to be careful sharing what comes from Sean on screen.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Ello, it's a much better situation than before.
Oh,
you got some help while we were here. Okay, good, 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 good.
Nice.
Yeah, and I think I told Jess what happened that night. What pissed me off is I came in the house, and I was standing there taking my shoes off, and he came out from, I guess, their house. You could walk a circle around the inside of it, right? You could go from the kitchen through the living room over to the bedroom into the back, come through the other room, come down the hallway, come out through the gangkon, and then back into the kitchen, right? It's like a big square, right? Mm. So anyway, I was coming in the house. Mm-hmm. And I've never met the guy in my life, right? And this is his house. And he comes out from the bedroom, coming down the hallway.
Mm.
And I said, "Hey, how you doing?" And he ignored me and just walked right past me. And I'm like, this is, dude, seriously, are you kidding me?
Mm.
Like, this is your house. Like, you're not greeting your guests. I don't know. That kind of that really dug at me.
Well, he probably was in the PC mood that day.
And probably drinking.
Or moment when he met you.
Well, I'll just say this. We love Jess. I don't really like him too much. Okay. Mitt Thakur says, "Hi, Molly."
Hi.
Mark, vertical smoker. Okay. Sorry. Okay, hold on. Before we get into this, I'm going to share these pictures.
Sean's.
The Sean sent. Okay. Yeah. Here we go. Hopefully this. Does that show up?
Yep.
Okay, that's a crock pot.
Okay.
Okay, and that, you know, that looks exactly like an Instapot.
Right.
Hmm.
Well, it's just the same thing, but by different maker.
And then the vertical smoker.
Ooh.
Look at that.
Oh my God.
Sean, do you have one of these big smokers? I can just see you out there smoking. Hmm. Mm. Oh, let's see. Jess says, yeah, he's not great in social situations. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Almost bought one of the electric smokers. Mm-hmm. No, not the big green egg. It's a square vertical. Yeah. So, yeah, you know, this is actually kind of turning into a cooking podcast.
Okay.
Nay. Mm. Maybe that'll be our theme each week, is what we cooked in the Instapot. Now, how many people out there call it Instapot? I call it Instapot, but it's actually Instant Pot.
Instant Pot. But when you say fast, you just lose the sound.
I say Instapot. I don't pronounce
it. Easier to say it too. Yeah, right. I hear a lot of people say it's just Instapot.
Judy says the Ninja Foodie thing is on sale at Costco for $149.
Oh.
There you go. Yeah. Hmm. Well, we will look at our Costco. Never know.
Well, it took 2-3 years to get in Japan. So it'll be taking another 2-3 years to get the Ninja.
Mm. In Japan. Right. And we will be going to Costco this evening.
Yep. Yep.
Mm. Yep. So that there's that. Mm. She's not sure if the base will have it. Well, I tell you what, one thing I may want to look at, Jess, if we do come up and go to the base, the furniture store, and see if would it be at all possible to get a sofa off base?
Well, I'm not sure.
If we could find a good sofa. And she says yes. Okay, there we go. Okay, so our sofa has right there behind Tomoko there on the picture.
I'm gonna sit on it though. I'm leaning against it.
Well, the left side and the right side are up higher than the center because my big ass has crushed the center down pretty tight.
Yeah, you only sit on the same spot. So
she says no, sorry, Jess, with my diabetes, I can't have root beer unless they've got diet. Mm-hmm. In that case, party on, Garth. She says they won't deliver that far, but she'll have a minivan. Oh, just deliver it to your house. We'll come get it.
Mm-hmm.
We'll get a truck or a van or something. We'll get it. Mm. Eggs, $300 to $400 for a green egg steamer or the cooker.
So the green eggs is the name of the vertical smoking stove.
Hmm. Hmm.
So smoking means cook for smoke with the smoke, like a bacon or ham and stuff like that.
Let's see. Jess says they shipped all their stuff Monday. Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. Oh, really? Okay. To Japan? And kept the big sofa they had before here because it's doing the same kind of dipping. Yeah.
Mm. You already sent out on the ship.
Mm-hmm.
It takes a couple of months, so that's about right.
True. Probably comes by ship.
Yeah. Cargo.
Literally. Kamado or big green egg.
Okay.
The Kamado green egg cooker, whatever it is. I guess it's the Stanny. Mark Hartino says the Kamado egg was invented by a Western guy who was inspired by the Japanese rice cooker while on a trip in Japan. Yeah. Okay, well, now I'm going to have to pull this up.
Kamado's the old-time cooking stove.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like at a period or somewhere time, the cooking stove is called Kamado.
Oh, okay. I see what this is. It's a grill.
Which is?
Here we go. It's a grill. Like this.
Mm. Okay.
Interesting.
Google Kamado.
Uh-huh.
Can you write Japanese hiragana Kamado? And
maybe
on image. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. An image. Search an image.
Oh,
yeah.
There you go. Sure.
That's Kamado. There's a space to put the pieces of wood to put the fire on and cook rice. This is for rice. This is your appointed.
Right.
You can cook it. Yeah.
Okay, so Mark, when he says that it was inspired by a Japanese rice cooker,
yeah,
you should maybe the traditional Japanese rice cooker rather than this.
Right.
Because the Japanese rice cooker. Eric cooker is like this.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay. Interesting. So anyway, that's all that was going on this week, right? We had the typhoon and
a lot of things happened in 1 week.
What's that?
We had a lot of things happened in the one week.
Yeah, that was this week in Japan, wasn't it?
Mm.
You and your poison ivy and...
Mm. Well, typhoon.
Typhoon.
And what else?
I think that was about it. It was a four-day weekend this weekend, so we were off Friday, Saturday, today, and tomorrow.
Yeah. Yeah, we had a day off on last Friday.
Mm.
And you and I went to the immigration office to renew
my foreign registration card. Right. That's right. Yeah. So that's what Friday was. Friday was going to immigration.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Do this. Too big. Yeah, I had to go to immigration and do my card, mm-hmm. but that was pretty painless.
Mm, no.
We were there.
Yeah.
Now,
it was smooth.
Right. So here's the thing. Mm-hmm. As most of the people that follow us know, I don't walk very far because I'm so heavy. It wears me out, kills me. And I need to walk more. I know that. But anyway, when we went to immigration, mm-hmm. Tomoko dropped me off in front of the building. And then she went to find a parking space.
Mm.
Now, the place where I usually park is like a block and a half up the street, and that's why I wanted her to park it, and I would wait for her at the place.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I get out of the car, and Tomoko turns a hard right and goes directly across the street. There was this little tiny parking space that I had never seen before, and it was mm-hmm. directly across the street. Like, oh, well, if I knew you're parking there, mm-hmm. I didn't need to wait here. You know, I could have walked from there because just across the street. Mm-hmm. But when I got out of the car, I told her, I said, you know, I'll sit here on this. There was like this little thing of bricks. And I said, well, I'll sit here on this little wall and wait for you. Mm-hmm. So I get out of the car and I see her turn over in that parking lot. And I'm like, oh, okay. Well, all right. Well, I'll just sit here and wait for her. So I start over to where those bricks are.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a window behind them and there was a girl sitting inside. And I thought, oh, if I sit here, she might come out and say something to me not to sit there. Because it's right out in front of their shop, right?
Right.
So I thought, okay, well, screw it. I'll stand here. Mm-hmm. So I thought, she's just across the street. I can stand that long. It's not going to hurt my back that much. So mm-hmm. I leaned up against the wall and I saw you pull into the parking lot.
Mm-hmm.
And then I saw you backing out. And I thought, oh, there must not be a parking space. Now she's got to go find a parking space. And I was like, screw this. I'm not standing here that long. And mm-hmm. I took off. So I went upstairs. I thought you'll message me. You'll know that I went upstairs.
Right.
So I went upstairs and like 2 minutes later, mm-hmm. like I hadn't sat down 2 minutes mm-hmm. and she messages me, have you gone up already? And I was like, oh, that mm-hmm. was quick. Mm-hmm. So when I got there, mm-hmm. When I first went into the building, I went to the elevator and there mm-hmm. was a sign taped to the just under the elevator button. Which mm-hmm. is usually the way they do it when the elevators are closed down.
Right.
And I saw this sign. It said something about 9 to 12. And I was like, oh, shit. Like, I'm not climbing six flights of stairs. If I have to go up six flights of stairs, I'll come back another day. Mm-hmm. Right. Because I said the S word. That's fine. We're good.
No. I did.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. So I was like, yeah, I'm not climbing six flights of steps. Mm-hmm. And I pushed the button and the elevator door opened. And it looked like the walls were covered in carpeting, like mm-hmm. when you're moving something dirty. Mm-hmm. And they put that rough carpeting over it. It looked like a service elevator, kind of. Right. And I thought, well, this is strange. And I thought, well, oh, well. So I got in the elevator, pushed the sixth floor and went on up. Got mm-hmm. out, went in the place, got my papers, sat down. Mm-hmm. Like 3 minutes later, I get a message from Tomoko. Or did you go up? And I said, yeah, come on up. And I'm waiting. Finally, she comes in and she's like,
yeah.
And I said, what? And she said, the elevator's not working. And I was like, what? I said, I just came up on the elevator.
Right.
Well, when Tomoko came in, there was somebody standing there that told her she couldn't take the elevator.
Yeah. There was a guy and older lady were there. The guy was walking on the elevator to changing the carpet inside or something, the cleaning or something. And there's two elevators, but one is already closed. The other one is he's working on it. And there's another lady was standing by him. And I saw the paper, like you saw that on the buttons of the elevators. So I thought maybe he's changing the carpet, temporary, not
going to take long.
Yeah. So I asked the ladies if I can use the elevator. She gave me the big sign like this. So I thought that I couldn't use it. Mm. I didn't even ignore her. I didn't even try to ignore her to try to use the other one. I just heard her gesture and I have to climb the stairs.
So
I knew that was sixth floor that the immigration office was, but I didn't mind climbing using the stairs. But six stalls.
Yeah. So now the funny part of this is Tomoko's standing there going like that, right? Yeah. And she's kind of breathing heavy. I just came up six flights of steps. And behind her, the elevator door opens up because you could see out into the hallway. And the elevator door opens up and a couple people walk in. I was like, people are coming out of the elevator right there behind you, hon.
I know.
You poor thing.
The lady gave me the sign. No sign. All she had to do is just tell me that the other elevators can use it, not this one.
Right.
She just told me no.
Right.
Then I just didn't want to go farther.
Right.
So, but well, it was a good exercise anyway.
Well, here's the thing. You know how to tell if an elevator is not working or not? Mm-hmm. Uh huh. Huh?
What?
Wait a minute.
I don't know.
Do you know how to tell if an elevator is not working or not? That's not the way it works. That's not how. I said that totally wrong. Do you know how to tell if an elevator is working or not?
Yes.
Do you know how to tell?
No.
If it's not working, I'll be standing there waiting.
Oh, that's true.
Because my big ass isn't going to climb six flights of steps.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, Bill is asking.
Hi, Bill.
You still need that card if you have permanent residency. Yes. Yeah. It's like an ID card. I'm still a foreigner.
If you change the nationality, so you don't need a card. Become Japanese.
Now, here's the thing. I don't have to have my visa renewed. I never have to do that. I have a permanent residency, so my visa doesn't get renewed. But I do have to get my card updated every couple of years.
Or like a driver's license have to renew.
Yeah. Similar, exactly. Yeah.
Exactly the same, right? Yeah. Every 5 years, 3 years or 5 years, right. So we have to renew our driver's license. If you don't do that, you lose your driver's license. But okay. If you don't renew your card, what's going to happen?
I don't know.
Your visa not going to go anywhere, right?
Right. Judy says, I always take the stairs. I'm one of those people.
I do. I do take stairs.
You do, don't you?
Hmm. I never tried to use the elevator or escalators. But six stores is a little bit more than that you want.
Right.
And a small building with the sharp stairs. Yeah. It's pretty good exercise.
Let me ask you, when we go to the dentist,
do you come up the steps?
No.
Yes, I climb steps. Mm. Well, when I come out from the parking, the stairs is true.
It'd be just as much go around the building, wouldn't it?
Yeah. And even I ignore the stairs and use the elevator, I have to still walk the long hallways to get to the dentist.
Mm, right.
Office is okay. It's at the far end of from elevator.
Right.
So.
Okay. Thomas has an iPhone question. He says, I have a question about the iPhone. I'm thinking of getting my first iPhone. I have an Android and I'm good with switching, but what size? 64 gigs, 128, 256 and 10 cheaper or the 11. Well, okay. Here's the thing about the size of the hard drive size, mm-hmm. 64, 128, or 256. That is entirely up to your habits. I've got the 256, I think. I've got the 10X. I always say this the wrong way. I always say iPhone 10XS, but the X is the 10.
Okay.
So it's iPhone XS.
Okay.
It's not iPhone 10XS.
Okay.
But that's what I say, so screw it. I've got the iPhone 10XS, and mine is...
You get the biggest, second biggest.
Mine's 256.
Right. So is mine, I believe.
Mine's 256, which I think is the biggest.
No, there's a bigger...
Oh, 512. They had 512, didn't they?
Yeah.
Okay. Here's the thing, Thomas. For myself, I could probably get away with the 64 gigabyte model. Mm. I don't keep anything. Mm. Whenever I shoot videos, I move them over to the computer, upload them to YouTube, and then I throw them away. I don't even keep them on my computer. Mm. Okay. So you could get away, like if you don't keep a bunch of stuff. Mm-hmm. Okay, so mine's a 256, mm-hmm. and I've got 199 available.
Mm. Yeah, so, you don't need a big phone.
Yeah, 128 would probably be perfect for me. Because I do keep my pictures, right? And my pictures take up more space than anything.
But we use Google Photos, so we actually don't need to big space on a phone.
Right. But, you know, so all of my pictures go to Google Photos automatically. Mm. And which is cool, but at the same time, there are a bunch of pictures you don't want to delete off your phone because, oh, I might show this to somebody or,
right. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So depending on what how much stuff you want to keep on your phone, like if you're like me where you throw things away, it's not really a big deal. Mm. Right. So 64 or 128 would probably be fine. As for the 10 or the 11, what's that?
Of course, 10 is cheaper.
Right, 10 is cheaper. I'm completely happy with my 10. I don't see any reason to upgrade at this point in time. The iPhone 11 doesn't have all those options, so many options that I feel like I need to upgrade. Mm. I had thought about it when it first came out, but then the reality hit me that I don't need to. There's no reason to spend that kind of money. So, you know, if you can catch a break on the 10, yeah, go for the 10. And I would recommend getting the biggest one, the 10X, the XS.
The bigger screen.
Yes. Yeah, the big screen. Yeah. The flagship model. Mm.
Easier no, to.
Sorry, I want to catch up with some comments here real quick. Okay. Judy says when she did her kidney donation, she would take stairs up and down to and from the 19th floor. Jesus Christ!
Oh my God! 19th floor? Jesus.
That's insanity.
Yeah.
That makes me tired just reading it. Let's see. Sean says, stay Android. The iPhone 10 and 11, if the back glass breaks, costs over $400 to have fixed. And only Apple can't do it. No aftermarket can't fix it because of the glue they're using. Yeah, I was just watching a video on that yesterday. Mm-hmm. This guy's got this laser thing that he can take the glass off of the iPhone. Mm-hmm. Some special glue that they're using. And they do charge ungodly amounts. But, you know, Sean, here's the thing. If you get a good case and you're just careful with your phone, it's not going to break. You know, I've been using, I don't understand people. We've been using iPhones since the 3G, 3GS, and I've never had a crack on any of my glass. Now you got a crack over your camera lens one time.
Yeah.
But it actually,
I don't know how that happened.
But it actually was a perfect spot right over the lens.
Yeah.
So it didn't affect your picture taking.
No. Yeah. The glass was broken. It got a cracks and everything, but the picture quality wasn't affected at all. It
wasn't affected at all because the hole that was in the glass was exactly over the lens. I don't know how the hell you did that. Anyway, so, you know, if you're careful with your phone, just get a good case. Thomas says he uses his camera a lot. 128 would probably be good. Yeah. Simon's here. Hi, Simon. Wait a minute, Simon. Aren't you supposed to be in a show right now, or was that yesterday? Oh, that would have been last night, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, just had to go?
Oh.
Yeah, she says, oh, sorry, I missed that. Got to go. Love you guys. Glad I could catch you live. There we go. Okay, bye, Jess. Aww. Even though you're not hearing us. Judy says, faster than the stupid elevators. Oh, wait a minute. Faster than stupid elevators at the hospital, going up those 19 floors.
Really?
Yeah. Looks like Sean was looking at the same video that I saw, the guy with the laser.
Oh, okay.
Taking the glass off the back.
I know this place in Shizuoka had to have to fix the iPhone specifically.
Right. But the 10, starting from the 10, they're using a special glue to hold the glass on that only Apple can take it off.
Okay. And we have the SoftBank has a package offers to customers. So if you pay extra money, but if your iPhone broken, you can get really cheap to fix. Like almost 10% of the what it costs.
Right. Now Sean says that he uses OtterBox cases, and they warranty any damage to the phone if it's damaged. So that's good. They do make good cases. I do know OtterBox.
We use
Urban Armor gear. Yeah.
Yeah. We've been using this for how many models? 2-3 models, right?
Yeah. I think this is our third. Yeah.
Yeah. Since the 7, 6 or 7.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
show the door on that, babe.
Yeah. This one has a door, but they have models don't have doors.
Okay. Close it so you can. Like this. And then it's got that little tab is magnetic, and it.
Yeah. So when you close it, it's closed with the hair.
Right.
Get the sound.
Oh, hold on.
When you close it, this has a magnet inside, and when you close it, can you hear the sound? Click. Does it catch up? Can you hear it?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. It catches. Yeah.
And it has a little slit to keep cars. I never put anything here, but
now I'm gonna drop you off just for a second, babe.
Okay.
Yes. But you'll be able to see, but you won't be able to say anything. Okay. Okay, so I've got the same case. The black line on mine, I attempted to do Van Halen stripes and gave up on the first line. So this is my case. The same as Tomiko's. It's got the little magnetic flap here, and you can hear it. You can hear that. And it just opens up and got your phone there. And it's got these hard corners on them. Oh, there we go. It's got these hard corners. So basically, it's fine. These are.
God, you don't have to do that far.
You know what?
The picture is through the way.
You're not going to believe this.
Uh-huh.
That actually landed in the garbage can.
Really?
Yeah, okay. I heard it. I heard it hit the pet bottles.
Yeah, I heard it too, but
I had a nice swoosh in the over the shoulder, straight into the trash can. Oh yeah, three-pointer there.
Jesus.
But anyway,
you don't have to do that.
Oh no, I cracked my glass. No.
Well, I've dropped my phone so many times and never got damage on.
Yeah.
This case is perfect.
Yeah.
It's not expensive either.
Now this might be a bunch of horse crap, but
maybe it's expensive. I don't remember.
This might be a bunch of horse crap, but mm-hmm. It says they're military grade tested. Right. Yeah. That was like the thing, right? So, but you're supposed to, I think it says it's got a drop thing of like 6 meters.
Hmm.
Five or six meters you can drop. Yeah. Yeah.
This case, it's a bit heavy.
Mm, right.
So I like this weight, this heavy feeling. So I can feel the phone is in my hand. This makes me a little comfortable. That's a good thing too.
There, that's the
what
is urban armor gear. That's the UAG. That is the name of the company that makes our cases.
Yeah. Oh, is it?
Urban Armor Gear. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I like it too. I like the heavy case. I like that it's a little thicker. To be totally honest, I don't really like that the phones keep getting thinner and thinner. They're harder to hold when they get so thin.
Yeah.
Okay. Hobby H is saying Typhoon. I think he asked this before and I didn't purposely skip it. You know, the Typhoon came through yesterday and it wasn't anything here where we were. We were stocked up with food. We had the bathtub filled with water. We were ready to go. And, it just, nothing happened where we're at. Just had some rain and a little bit of wind.
Yeah.
But places around us were flooding and stuff like that. So I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
We are very, very lucky. Some other places have flooded and grow something and get damage on the house and stuff like that. So.
Let's see. Sean sent another picture.
Okay.
Let's see. Oh, yeah. I know these cases. I know the OtterBox. This is the one Sean uses. There you go.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
OtterBox Defender Series. Does that have a front door? Does that have a door on it? Yeah, I like having the door.
Me too.
Cover that glass, yeah.
More protective.
Mm.
We used to use
Mophie,
yeah.
We used the Mophies for the longest time.
Yeah. They're good, but they're expensive. And
yeah. Well, the thing with the Mophie is their charger case.
Yeah.
So if your battery ran out, you could flick a switch and it charges your battery.
Right. I've used knockoff Mophie cases too, like made in China.
Yeah.
And they're good. I never got a long one before.
Mm.
But I don't know. Maybe this one's good enough. You don't. Then iPhone got improved to have a longer life on batteries.
Right.
Don't worry about running the battery out anymore. So
yeah. Sean says the case is hard. Oh, sorry. Ha DH says stay safe. Thank you so much. Yeah, the Typhoon wasn't anything where we were here. At least not at our house.
Mm.
So yeah, thanks for that. And I'm not complaining. Let's see. Sean says the case is hard plastic with a screen protector and then a rubber plastic that wraps around the hard one. Okay. Kind of.
Well, I use the protector. Do you use it? Oh, yeah, you must use the one. I bought this protector off the Amazon. The two seats came in one package. Then
the clear protector over the screen?
Yeah.
No, I'm not using one right now.
Oh, you took that off?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. I'm using it. I never have fun without it. I like naked screen.
Thomas is asking, who the hell thumbed down this live stream? Thomas, I've got a hater. I'm pretty sure I know who it is. We'll just leave it at that. He's an asshat. I'm pretty sure I know who it is.
You believe so?
Yeah, I'm almost positive. Yeah, Mark. Mark's saying up or down, they both help with the algorithm. Yeah, that's exactly it. The thumbs down don't bother me because that means that they clicked on my video and they gave me a view.
Hmm.
You know, I dislike this person so much that I won't even thumb down their videos because I have to click on their video. I'm not giving them any. Wow. I'm not giving them any traffic.
Hmm.
No way. Anyway, screw him. It's no big deal. He's a loser. So anyway, let's not defile our good podcast over that dumbass. I have one cracker left.
Okay.
One more cracker. This is the last one.
Okay. How'd your shake?
We're fine.
Okay.
These crackers are okay. They're just plain crackers.
I think that's a known brand that maybe a Walmart original. I don't know that I bought it at the CU. The supermarket has a business cooperation with Walmart, so they have a lot of Walmart products, great values. They used to have more, but not now. The crackers may be one of those.
Judy says she went back to sub at the high school. Well, hold on. She's doing a long-term job in the study hall. One science teacher has a cert just like yours, Molly. Yes. Good taste. EQ'd? What's that?
I have no idea.
What is EQ'd?
Yeah.
Grocery store. What are these random words here? EQ'd, grocery store.
EQ is a grocery store.
Okay. Thomas says the iPhone 10 with 128 will be the big iPhone 10 with the 128 will be the goal unless the 11 is offered for a good price. There you go. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You know, if you can get the 11 at the same price, always go with the newer one, you know?
The apples never get priced down till the new products come out. So if
you know what, to tell the truth, I think if I'm not mistaken, I think the 11 was actually cheaper than the 10.
Really?
Yeah, I think so.
Huh.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the thing is, when we buy the new phone, we usually go through the carriers and they have this contract deal,
right?
So we actually don't pay full price on the phone,
right? Let's see. The iPhone 11 Pro Max, that's the one, right? Space gray. Oh, Thomas, they've got 64, 256 or 512. This is on the new one. So we'll go 256 on that one. And you're looking at $1,200.
It's about the same price as 10.
I think the 10 was 15, wasn't it, over here?
When it came out, about the same price, I believe. Well, the bigger, it become more expensive the bigger giga you get. So.
Oh, hold on.
What?
On the iPhone, on the Apple homepage, iPhone XS is not available anymore. What's XR?
Oh, I don't know.
XR must be, it must be the XS isn't available on this, on their homepage anymore. So there you go. You might as well just go ahead and go with the 11. They're not showing the XS Max available.
Unless you get at the discount store or something. Second hand.
Right.
Well, I think second hand phones are good enough too. 10 is only 1 year old, so it's still good to go.
Mark Hartman says the E-Cute seems to be a mall in Shinagawa.
Okay.
Ecute. I wonder what how you pronounce it.
Ecute. I don't know.
They have the 11, not the 11 Pro. Oh, well, you want the... No, they'll have the Pro. If you want the Pro, they'll get you the Pro. Ooh. Anyway, well, I guess that's about it for this week, huh, Mama?
Yep.
Yeah, that was fun.
Yep.
Okay. So, anyway, I guess there is little Opie. We can't go an episode without mentioning Opie.
You cuteness.
Yeah. Well, I guess I will come downstairs and we will have some lunch.
Yep.
And then we will figure out our goal for Costco tonight.
Yeah.
Oh, and Bill, hi, I did. Bill, I did see your message earlier. I did not ignore it. He said he needed proof that the house was okay. By showing old Pink. This is Bill's favorite. I just put a new block in the back of it. This block here. Just put the new block in. Nice big fat block. Now they say these things help with tone and sustain, and there is a noticeable difference since I've put it in. But I don't know if it's the block or the strings, because I put new strings on it and the strings are a different string gauge. I went from 9 to 42 to 9 to 46. So that's going to definitely affect the tone. But it's definitely a...
Daddy?
Huh? What's that?
Hoping to see Daddy.
Okay. So yeah, Bill, old Pink's fine.
We have nothing to broken or fall off or anything.
Nothing. Not a thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was too loud for this room. Okay. All right. Well, I guess we will cut it here, Mama.
Okay.
Thanks for
joining. Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks, guys, for joining us today. And we will see you next week. Maybe next week. Tomoko's got a hair appointment at 2 o'clock next week.
No.
It's tomorrow.
We have nothing next week, probably.
Okay. Well, for now, I guess we'll see you guys next week.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks so much for joining everybody.
Yes. And we'll
see you next time.
See you. See ya.
Goodbye. Bye. Ending broadcast. Bye. You ready? Say goodbye, yeah. Mrs. Mama.
Goodbye.
Well, hold on. Sorry. Sakana Kaizen says, I'm relieved the typhoon didn't do too much damage in your corner of Japan. Much love to Opie. Good night. Yeah. Yeah. Good nothing. Night. Nothing here. Yeah.
Good morning. Okay, guys. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.